feature of the night, brought to you by Christopher Cronus Promotions. And have a look at them. Too numerous to mention, but the person that will follow them out is slowly but surely making a name for himself in this country and a legend in the sport. And also is making a name for himself overseas as well. It's the Australian and World Heavyweight Champion, Stan the Man, Longanini.
Now, there's any challenge to beat this man fair. You have to really keep this, and then you have to really keep his side strong and ignore this crowd reaction of Stan the Man Longanini. Okay, let's just get to him. It's not going to make it easy fighting for him. And Stan's got the showmanship down 2-2. He knows exactly now how to win a crowd over.
And of course, what does he do? He goes straight over to the opposition corner. And fight tonight, which Mandinga will have against Stan the Man Longanini. Although he has fought him before on one occasion, some years back. He's going to learn a lot from it. Fellow is probably not one of those awesome kids we've seen in this country, and it's got one hell of a whack to follow it up as well.
It was a controversial decision last time, which will be interesting tonight. I'm sure Mandinga's out to save face for that. He feels he should have kept fighting, but interesting enough, it's the same referee, Dave Edgecock, at their last encounter. He stopped the fight due to a low kick that the belt injured Mandinga and didn't allow the fight to continue.
Let me tell you a little bit about Elizabeth from Queensland tonight. Mitch Mandinga is a 22-year-old who has had plenty of pro and amateur boxing fights. He's only had 12 kickboxing fights, but he has had 9 wins and 3 losses. He fought Stan some 4 years ago in Melbourne.
We've had Test cricket, and now we've got Stan the Man, the Clipsal powerhouse. The Adelaide 36ers, hometown. Okay, our ring ladies, Senior and Jennifer, the two lovely ladies. Our ringside physician, Dr. Felino McNody. Referee Dave Hitchcock, judges Mel Porter, Neville Williams, Nick Ceruto. Timekeeper Andrew Easton. Ladies and gentlemen, when Dave gives the ring instructions, then we'll officially introduce the contestants. This world title eliminator, the winner to meet Dennis Alexio, December 6th in Melbourne Town. We're ready to rumble. 10 rounds occupying the blue corner. From the Valley Gymnasium in Brisbane, 25 amateur and professional kick fights and conventional fights, with former Australian featherweight champion Con Russell in the corner, getting 94 kilograms. Recently beat Grant Barker, former world title challenger from Sydney Town. Marveling at magical mayhem, Mitch Mandinga. Occupying the red corner, the greatest ever kickboxing champion, holding 7 individual titles, 2 WKA heavyweight championships of the world, 27 years of age, 24 wins in 26 contests. He boxed in Las Vegas, Caesars Palace, Hollywood, and Long Beach, getting 94 kilograms, making his Adelaide debut at the Clipsal powerhouse, evolving imaginary of metaphorical mystique, the thunder from down under,
truth for young Mitch Mandinga, and we say young at 22 versus Stan the Man at 27 years of age. And I kept an eye on him, Bobby, throughout all that hype which went around our Australian and world champion, and unfazed by it all is our friend from Queensland.
I hope so. That'll make this a good fight. Mandinga needs to be unfazed by the hype that surrounds Stan the Man Longanini right now. He needs to be very aggressive as the fight progresses, and he needs to load his power. If he doesn't, he's going to go down like everybody else does.
Well, both fighters, a big kick there from Longanini, just misses the mark.
Mark. And the Queenslander after it, and under the ropes. Got a height. And Richard Bartage over Longanides. And it's went in underneath and puts Longanides on the back.
That's
foot.
Amazing, guys.
And Longanides now goes to down and tries to find the mark quickly with the hand. And I think Mitch might have stung him with one. And that forced
right hand, Mitch.
Longanides into action. Left and right combinations. And plenty of work underneath as well.
Work, Mitch, work.
It's very hard to get up and come fighters now. Mitch Sanders has so much international experience in sport all over the world.
Mitchell!
He is the world champion. I'd hate to be an underdog coming up under Sam Longanides now. It's going to be time as Sam gets older. The only thing that's going to slow this machine down.
Well, he just let the hand go there on the Queenslander. The Queenslander just didn't even budge. So he can take a punch.
And he also puts his hand nice and as I said, he needs to not be affected by the height. He needs to be serious. He needs to be confident and want to beat Stan. And he's going to have to hit Stan with some good shots to turn this fight around and make it a battle.
10 2-minute rounds.
I don't think Mando can win this. Mandinga can win this, even if he does all of the above that I just mentioned. But he can make it a difference. If he makes any mistakes, Stan does have a habit of knocking people out.
Well, as I said before, this is the moment of truth. Second time he's had a chance to have a crack at Longanides. He's lost his footing and going backwards. There's the end of round one. And the young Queenslander's caught Longanides with a couple. Having a look at the back of the thigh, there's a couple of good red welts there. So he's got plenty of thinking to do. He's just got to remain focused and remain all about the whole thing.
You roll along at any time you want.
Give it to me.
I'm going to go to the hospital. He was just quite calm about the whole thing. No more Stan, the man Longanides fighting around this side.
Well, that person didn't show us, I think Stan sort of put, you know, he's got a bit cranky there when he caught a straight right and unloaded a couple, but of course he always went to the fight. As he can, he builds his load a little bit more and a little bit more, which makes it very hard against the challenger. He says, God, the more rounds we have, the harder this man gets to fight. But of course, you know, I don't want to make Mandingo sound like that he's a foregone loser. This is kickboxing, and a big right hand over the top at any time can put anybody to sleep. And Mandingo looks like he's quite capable of doing that. I'm discussing quite a bit. Here's Stan, putting the pressure on Mandingo, handing it, giving him a smile.
A little bit of cheek coming there as Stan gives him his best, and he comes up smiling at him. Loads up the punches, Mandingo, but just a little bit sloppy. Not finding the mark. Longanides, sharper.
But Mandingo's quite capable of knocking out as well. He's not as impressive in his record as Stan Stockhouse, but he knocked Van Barker at the same time. And he had a couple of fights in New Zealand against very hard Maori boys over there to knock them out.
Working so on that left.
Stan won't want to let him sort of get him clean on the team.
Working on that left leg of Stan's.
Jab it, Mitch. Jab on the way in, Mitch.
Longanides going inside. Cummings, the right hand, follows up with the left and then a right kick.
It's that little change of direction Stan's got down there. As he runs in to do that power, what we call a chopper kick to the thigh, he switches his footwork on the way in and it misleads the fighter. He doesn't quite know where he's coming from or which leg's going to fire. Because at that point, Stan could go left leg inside the thigh or he can shuffle a little bit further and go over the top with the right leg onto the thigh. So it's very confusing for a fighter looking at that coming down. It's, you don't know which leg's going to hit you. I've noticed in his last couple of fights, he did that quite nicely against Grant Barker in Sydney as well, and that's the first time he's used it tonight. Just a interesting little switch if you watch it on the video. Next time you see Stan coming in, and if you catch him using that tricky little bit of footwork.
I think Mitchell's got to, again, acknowledging Longanides. He's got a bit of cheek in him. Got a bit of cheek in him, and Stan gives him a push away as if to say, hey. But he's keeping his distance from Longanides, and I think he's got to do that. If he's going to pick him off at any time, he can't afford to let Longanides get in close.
defensive point in this time, too. Yeah, some of those bombs that he's loading up. Lucky he's off cue a little bit at this early stage of the fight, because it might have been over already. But
well,
I probably said that a little bit too much. Because Mandinga now is doing what I hoped he would do. He's keeping his distance and he's loading his own shots. And he's making a fight of this. This might go on for the whole 10 minutes and be quite a war.
Be magnificent if it could. But we haven't seen Longanini's power punch that comes whereby the punch comes from the air and the body is completely off the ground.
That looping left.
Oh,
I feel that one little bit every time. When you get an airborne and that left just rolls
over. We may see it tonight, we may not. But when you see it come, it usually puts the opposition to sleep. Stand the man Longanini's out of the red corner from Taylor's Lakes in Victoria. And he's fighting Mitch Mandinga from the fight centre in the valley in Queensland. Round three.
That's it, Mitch.
And the Queenslander poking out the left hand. Longanini's coming in underneath.
He's going to have to watch that if he lets stand. Off the right leg. Comes over and down like thunder from down under.
I love the way the Queenslander acknowledged one when he gets hit.
And a smile every time.
Oh, there it comes. Oh. An inside leg kick down
back
the
up,
park.
Off the right.
And he has him in a neutral corner. But
kick out, me.
As if to say, come and get me.
I think Stan's relaxing and he's getting up to him. And Mandinga has acknowledging. Come on, let's get it on, he says. I can take a shot. Let's get it on, Stan. Come on.
Forget about it. Forget about it. Go, Mitchell. Forget about it. Get on with the fight. And
he's got the toughest, but he doesn't have the kit, does he? I'm just looking at the two fighters overall now. Mandinga doesn't have the kit. He's certainly got the confidence, which I was hoping he'd have.
I think by doing that, this is going to make Stan sit back, wait, pick his mark.
That's what he's
then
doing
good
right
night.
Now. Yeah, he's pulled back now. He's picking his shots.
Kick off, Mitch. Kick him, Mitch. Kick!
Well, Longanini gives him left and right. And those punches would fall any better, man. The Queenslander stands there and says, okay, now give me your best shot.
I think we've a tough one here. Oh, this is where those punches usually knock people out. And Mandingo's smiling and acknowledging them. I think he thinks they're a bit of fun.
You can't take them for 10 rounds,
no.
Tommy.
No,
you cannot take them for 10 rounds.
He's slowed down. Mandinga has slowed down. He's missing his loopy rights, and these big ones are coming in. I think he's starting to feel the effects of that terrible word concussion.
He's found his mark a couple of times, and we might get a chance to get a look at the right eye of the Longanini's in a moment. And even that left eye of the...
Look at Stan's lead leaders also. He's finding his mark, isn't he?
So I think this fella's doing a bit more damage than we're going to give him credit for.
And another round. We might have got the tits and affect ourselves here a little bit. He has given
Let's get
around.
In this corner here and see. Dana Goodson's now working on that eye of Stan's, or is he having a look at it?
Stan, move that fucking head,
Although we can see a bit of a graze from Stan's cop on there, just to the side of his left eye there. And just about where Dana Goodson is now. I reckon he's opened up a cut. I think Stan's eye there, so Stan's got to be very careful.
Also because Stan has a fight every 3 weeks now for Christmas. He's fighting three weeks in Greece, he fights in Japan, he comes back to fight Dennis Alexio in Melbourne.
Well, that's
then he's fighting in Sydney in January.
Mitchell, don't throw rubbish.
Come on, man, let's get it on.
Worries me how to see fighters. You know, start. There's only one bloke could ever do that. That was Muhammad Ali.
Eventually, he caught up. I think he's trying anything to try and get a stand, you know, and try and get a stand. But of course, too much experience. At least he's trying, and he's still there. This is round four, and he's still there. Not many fighters go four rounds with Stan Longanini, even though they get paid for 12.
Well, Mitch tries.
That's it, Mitchell. And the legs again, Mitch.
Looks for the big left lead, and it goes on its mark again. And both fighters now starting to have a bit more respect for one another. Oh, left and right combinations here, and a left again.
Legs, Mandinga.
Back and catches him with one. And he's going to mix it up and throw an inside leg kick in as well.
Left hand, Mitch.
Mandinga here.
Champion.
And a chopper, and a double hand technique.
Left hand!
Big punch.
thunderous chopper from Mandinga.
Get that jab, Walker! Get that jab!
The fight's every 3 weeks coming up. He won't want too many bruises on him.
Stan's starting to change tactics a little bit now. Left hand comes over the top and finds Longanides. A real jabbing right hand down the side of the Queenslander. Whoops. Well, if nothing else, I've never seen a fighter cop a couple, get into trouble, and still come up smiling. Left hand, the lead. Gets in by Longanides. Again, he gets in underneath. And I think Stan Lamont just got a little bit more respect for his opponent.
I think so. I think he's acknowledging that he's up against a tough dude here.
And it won't do him any harm either. Stan's fights don't normally go beyond two or three rounds. Tonight, he's got one that's into the fourth.
Work me.
That was my opening line. I was really hoping Mandinga would take Stan the distance because the quality of fighter Stan's got coming up. He needs distance fights now to keep checking his endurance level and how he handles the distance. Too many knockouts too often is not good for a world champion.
Well, Longanides makes his way back to the corner, and just a little slower, the Queenslander makes his way back. Boy, what an interesting night this final card's going to be.
He's done something a lot of fighters haven't done out of the 25, 30-odd fights that Stan's had. Not a high ratio of them have gone into what the rounds girl was telling us now, the fifth round.
Personally,
you want to take a break this week?
I know we're only halfway through the fight, but personally, I have Longanides in front just for the skills level.
Left hand, Mitch.
And we make our way into the fifth round. And Mandinga keeps working on that left leg of Longanides, who's now starting to really bruise up.
And he's still smiling. I mean, it might be upsetting Stan a little bit. I wouldn't think so with his world experience, but I mean, he is copping a lot on that lead leg. Stan is very bruised up on that lead leg. His eyes are bruised up. So Mandinga is placing those shots, which I think he'll help him do to make Stan work. This is a good fight making Stan work.
Starting right hand comes over the top from Longanides. There we go after the Queenslander. And the Queenslander comes back and he walks into another left hand from Longanides. But he puts Longanides back in his own corner. Now Longanides comes out and he smells victory. Left and right hand. The left hand caught him. The right one missed. Down the right overcut. And again, Longanides starts to smell a bit of victory as he pushes the Queenslander into the neutral corner. Tries to take him out with a leg kick underneath. And back he comes, the Queenslander. He's taken Longanides' his best shots and he's still there. The left hand, he pokes out at the champion and puts him back into his own corner. Longanides.
Rob, I can't believe he's riding those punches like he is. It's got to be affecting him. There were thunderous punches coming in.
Well, Longanides has just stood back and had a look at him as if to say, hang on, I've just given you half a dozen of my best shots and you haven't gone.
That's got to be telling on Stan as well. See, Stan's starting to do
Stan's
a roll
starting
over punches
to die a little
there
bit now.
Now.
But the left hand, the jab comes out. And the smile on the Queensland is still there. Walks into one. Longanides puts out the left lead and catches him. And he bounces onto the balls of his feet, the Queenslander. Again, both fighters lead out their hands. And Longanides, having a good look at him in the neutral corner, tries to bring him down. Now starting to catch him on that thigh.
Caught the lead leg. Stan's caught the lead leg. And didn't have to smile, but he felt those two on the lead leg. And that's going to affect his punching power because he can't put his weight heavy on that front leg now.
Good hand by Longanides. Follows it up with a left hand, and there goes the bell. We have a look at the Queenslander and he walks back into the corner as if to say, hell.
He's smiling at the audience, though. He gave you a smile and said, mate, I'm fine. Don't worry about what I look like.
Yeah, that jab bang worked. You didn't do it till the last minute, mate. Come on. All we got to do is jab bang.
What a game effort.
Okay? You're trying to play hero on you. Jab bang.
I have never seen anyone of Longanides' opponents smiling for five rounds and still say, come on.
I think it's the first time.
It's almost that cheekbone. He said to say, hey, you haven't given me your best shot yet. I just don't know.
Just starting to drop a little now. Spinning leg kick comes back out, doesn't find the mark, and chopping right hand there from the Queenslander. And he walks up to the champion again. Pushing up, leading out. And Longanetti's covering up. Now he starts to do a bit of work underneath, dodging and weaving. And both fighters just spending a little bit of petrol. And the Queenslander trying to catch Longanetti's. He can't do so. He gets him on the gloves. Now works onto that thigh again. Longanetti's comes back with a combination of punches. No damage done yet.
This could be the first round, Mandingo.
Oh, there's no damage. And an overhead, a clubbing overhead punch from Longanetti's. Oh, he follows him up now with the left and right. Now the challenger's in a bit of trouble. The Queenslander, just a little wobbly on the legs in centre ring. And equally as tired as Longanetti's. As you said, Bobby, this fight's going to do him the world of good.